To the members of the public watching, you should be shocked, appalled, and dismayed by what you're seeing in the Arizona State Capitol. As community leaders and elected officials, we said, go out and vote. And you did. In fact, you came out in record numbers in 2020. Thank you. And because you did, your reward has been an unprecedented effort across this country and here in this state to make it harder for you again next election. We've seen more than 350 different bills introduced across this nation to restrict, revoke, or make it more difficult to participate in democracy. If you ever believed your vote didn't matter, your voice didn't matter, let this bill remind you that it most certainly does. What we're seeing in this legislative body is an injustice to democracy, an injustice to the way we as Americans, as Arizonans, should have the right to participate in it. People in Arizona want to have the right to vote. They deserve the right to vote. And this bill will impede that right and kick 100 to 150,000 people off of the permanent early voting list. Democracy should be about the exchange of ideas, not political gamesmanship. Democracy should be about participation, not preventing access to democratic voices. This bill is not about election security. It's not about election integrity. It's about trying to game the system. The right to vote for people of color to live and the right to vote is inherently linked together. And on a day when people of color witness a small measure of justice with the conviction of Derek Chauvin, here in Arizona, we're taking a step backwards by now making it even more difficult for these same people to participate in democracy, to stand up and fight for justice. The effect of this bill will make it harder for independent voters, seniors, Native Americans, Black, Brown, and low-income people to vote.